Welcome back to Pinoy Bounce, and it's James, and we're talking about the player highlight of the week. And we're going to talk about Shaquille O'Neal. 27 years ago, he scored 24 points, 28 rebounds, and 15 blocks against the Chicago Bulls. And who broke that record is Shai Gilgeous-Alexander. He scored 20 points, 20 rebounds, 10 assists against the Minnesota Timberwolves. And a few days ago, Shai just played against the Raptors, and he played great. But Raptors won, and what do you guys think about that game?
Well, I mean, it's glad to see some of our
players
coming back from injury and everything, like Gasol, Norman, Siakam, Matt Thomas coming back too as well.
Mm-hmm. It's good to see Siakam on good shape. Like, literally, he came in and just balled.
He had a couple hiccups, though, for some of those games, like trying to play God and everything by taking the last shot. And when we lost, you already know what I'm talking about. No, but it's good to see them. I mean, we're just still waiting on Fred VanVleet on his return and everything too. So what do you guys think if we have Fred VanVleet coming back from our past games?
I even like look at the last like month or so, and we've had a lot of losses in terms of who our players were. And we had guys like Terrence Davis and Patrick McCaw on the starting lineup. And you think about all those players, and it's a testament to the Raptors team and their depth, but also Nick Nurse and what he's done as a coach to really get those guys to actually win games without majority of their star players. Mm-hmm. So I think the last few months has shown us what can happen when you get deep in the playoffs, and hopefully, you know, they go far again.
Mm-hmm. What has this done with Nick Nurse in terms of how he just kind of finds a way to position players to succeed? I don't know, it's so underrated to see, because he basically puts players like Terrence Davis, Chris Boucher, and all in positions where they can succeed. They don't need to exceed the kind of, they're not getting exposed in terms of the weaknesses and what they need to develop right now, but they're being kind of maximized in terms of...
He does expose his weaknesses to the public and everything. He's actually not afraid, like Nurse, he's not afraid to tell
people. And he calls it out.
He calls it out. Yeah. Maybe that's one of his, like, I don't know, coaching tactics for them to get into their heads to, like, you know, shape it up and everything like that. But I just feel like with Nurse's, maybe let's say techniques and everything, has been by far phenomenal to what he's been doing with our bench.
Then you hit it right on the nose. It's like his defensive structure is pretty sound, but he's not afraid to take risks.
Yeah.
Right. So he'll do a box and one in the playoffs, and he'll do all these
full court presses.
Like
college.
Yeah. He does a bunch of zone defenses that just kind of throws.
That's high school level.
Yeah. Right. Oh, high school. Yeah. Like, yeah. That's high school. Yeah.
So it's like it's one of those things where he's not afraid to test the waters to kind of see what the team is made of. Mm-hmm. And then he'll call players out. It's not about one player being on the team. It's about a whole culture that they're buying into. So when you remember Rondae Hollis-Jefferson coming onto the team, he was one of those guys that didn't show the defensive intensity that Nurse wanted. So Nurse called him out. And what do you get? You get a greater
player,
energy.
Right? He has got energy off the bench.
Even with Terrence Davis Jr. too.
Yeah. And they both said that they're the kind of players that, I need that. I need to be called out. I need to be accountable. And that's the kind of players you want to have in the team, you know?
Yeah, totally.
Instead of blaming other people for anything that's going wrong with the team, they take accountability and say, hey, I need to be better. This is what I need to improve in.
And, and I think that's so exciting heading into next year's free agency, right? Mm-hmm. So Giannis 21, like we all know what's going to happen. Mm-hmm. But when you set up a culture like this, it's so much easier
to attract
new talent, right? So like you got a championship under your belt. You got a work culture that people aren't afraid to kind of show that underdog mentality and buy into what they're all about. Mm-hmm. And then you've got all these undrafted guys who don't think they have such a big ego, and it's just about the team and about the culture and the diversity of the city and the country they represent.
Mind you, our development in the G League and then transitioning into the NBA has been
by far the best.
That's something that the NBA should be looking up to, right?
Yeah.
Is us.
If you look at the
totally,
if you look at the number of picks,
if
you look at the players that we have right now and the picks that they've been taken, right? Gasol, you got VanVleet, you got Siakam, you got even Lowry. Right?
Yeah.
So for someone like Giannis who sees the team and say, hey, I was a 15 pick. If I look at all these players, these are not lottery picks that I'm coming with, but like, they proved they were underdogs.
I think, wasn't
and they
the earliest, shoot? Like, what, 20th pick or whatever from our team?
I think so.
Yeah,
like,
I think around there.
Something like that. That was our highest pick for one of the players.
Yeah.
And don't forget our most important piece, right? Like, Masai is still with the team, and we need to make sure that, you know, when you're attracting a free agent like Giannis, relationships that have existed in the past.
Always had that in the past, right. So it helps.
It hopefully will help, right?
He does all these things that, I mean, Masai, what he does for when he does Giants of Africa, and he does all these outside work. It's breaking a difference to players that like Joel Embiid, Siakam, is the honest. They see that kind of work and they want to be surrounded by that kind of culture and that kind of vibe.
We'll never forget, Masai actually helped Giannis and his family come into the country, right? Like, so there's a history there, and hopefully not only does the diversity of the country really speak to Giannis and what he's all about, but like the fact that there's a rich history with it is
there's
is
an
helpful.
Appeal to it for sure. Mm-hmm. I mean, we can give him Pape and Danforth, if anything. Name a street after him.
It's going to be a long-sounding name.
This Giannis Drive.
Giannis Drive.
If we had to create a marketing scheme like we did with Kwan and I, what do you guys think?
Kwan
would
and
it be, what would it be called for Giannis?
Oh, God.
Like, oh, gosh. I can't even imagine.
Yeah. Like, what would attract someone like...
That's the hardest question I've ever been asked.
I never knew from the first place that, like, Kawhi was a foodie, right? So I can't even, like, tap into what Giannis really is. I just know that he's a beast on the court.
Yeah.
Right, yeah, so. just give him Greek Town.
Bro, just call I think we just day. Give him a street in Greek Town and that's it,
yeah.
Give him on the Danforth.
Yeah. I mean, James, anything else to end off this portion?
We're going to end it off with Hoops Mariosep. LeBron James in Pampanga. Check this out.